Frank Zappa and her mother were at the best place around. Some stupid with a flare gun burned the place to the ground. Smoke on the water, fire in the sky. Smoke on the water.
Are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen!
The way I see it, Barry, this should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
All you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never want to leave. Sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage
is just for the invited.
Backstage,
they've laid on everything. Backstage, da 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 da. Backstage, da 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 da. So, hi, darlings. This is a new location for Rudy Backstage. We are here with Mr. Nikodemus, Nikodemus, yeah, he can't spell, this is why this is in the wrong way. This is the place where I'm usually recording my German television show, Rudy Backstage, but today we are guests here. Hello, Niki.
Hi.
And he's my special guest for a special reason. Behind us is the beginning, can we take this off? No, I don't think so. This is a plaque which remembers the 5th of February, 1998, and it's the Queen Corner, and there will be more and more stuff, and that's why we start here today talking a little bit about the Queen Corner. So tell me, why did you start the Queen Corner?
Yeah, because on the 5th of February 1998, it was a very, very special day. It was Rudy's 40th birthday, and he got
Now everybody knows how old I am. Oh my God! See, I always wanted to pretend, Niki, that you're ruining my life. It's just a joke. Everybody can Google it anyway. So, yeah. Okay.
So, here in my place in Nicodemus happened a very, very great surprise party for Rudy, and the surprise band was
Queen.
And so it happened in the small town of Burgersdorf in my little club that the famous band Queen performed, especially for his birthday, and therefore we do have this little corner tour, and it, I always will remember that night.
Yeah, and it will be more and more. I promise to bring some gold records and some photographs. So this will be something for Queen fans or Brian May fans or Roger Taylor fans or Freddie Mercury fans who come to Vienna. We are actually physically a little bit outside. I was living here around the corner for 30 years in Burkersdorf, which sort of, almost belongs already to Vienna, yeah. But politically is a little town for yeah. itself. And it's about 15 minutes from Schönbrunn, yeah. depending on the traffic. So that's worth coming. He's a very nice guestgeber. I don't know what the English word is. Host, thank you very much. Yeah, I was just recording other things in German. Sometimes there are again bands playing, not Queen every week, but then there's excellent food. And so whenever you decide to come to Vienna, the Queen Corner, which will grow very quickly, is worth coming, because this, I mean, on this very place where we are now sitting, Brian May was standing over there. He was the drums of Roger, Spike Edney, and so on and so on. And they played Queen hits. And also, which was, I mean, I was standing over there, yeah. I was crying, remember? Yeah. There's even a photograph of me. Ooh, yeah. Because I was so happy. I was so happy. They played Hang On, Snoopy, Hang On, in a new version of Hang On, Rudy, Hang On. And Brian made a great guitar solo. And there's people today who still talk about that evening. Yeah. And this plaque. And this up here is some photographs. You see Brian May. You see Roger and Spike Edney, Peter Maffay, some other German and Austrian stars. So what does it mean to you personally and to your club and restaurant that actually Queen was here?
To be honest, I've been a huge Queen fan since I was a little boy, and I will always remember this night. And it was a very, very special experience for me to meet Brian May and Roger Taylor in person. And when they went up on the stage of my little club, it was like a once-in-a-lifetime moment for me, and I always really remember that. And nobody can take away that memory.
Well, it was also very special for me as well. I mean, to be honest, in my house, we had a cocktail, champagne thing.
Yeah.
Well, you've been there as well.
There, yeah.
For a little group of people, for like the VIPs and Roger and Brian. I remember Brian was coming with two really big, long packages.
Yeah.
And I thought, God, what is that? And it was from Africa to, what's the name of the animals who have the long... two giraffes made out of wood,
yeah.
directly from Africa as my birthday present. And then, of course, there was the usual champagne in the spirit of Freddie. And so I don't know, Roger also brought me a very nice present. So we had this cocktail over there. Then there was sound check. And then there was, other bands playing, very, very famous Austrian and German superstars, you know, there were also comedy stars, actors, God knows. And when I said you only get 40 once in your life, I had, if I remember correct, I had 3 days of celebrating. One day was in another club where we might come one day. It's called Metropole in Vienna. I was doing a reading, and we come to this Montreux reading later. And then the second day it was with my family, and the third day we said, okay, now we lassen die Sau raus. We celebrate in sex and drugs and rock and roll style. So, Niki, thank you very much. Is there anything that connects you with Queen apart from this evening? Like, you're singing a Queen song now?
No, but when I was young, I had 2 years with the band Queen and David Bowie, and so especially the song Under Pressure is the song for my life.
Okay, great. Well, Niki, thank you very much. We arranged, since we have this special thing today, that now my bodyguard, associate producer, personal assistant, cameraman, and a manager, Mr. Benjamin Leon Dolezal, now is so kind and joins me. Yeah. Hello, Benny. He's also in
Bye.
Charge. Thank you, Niki. Thank you very much.
Thank
yeah.
You.
Benny, we have just returned from Montreux.
Yes, we
have. And he starts now speaking French fluently. Merci beaucoup. I mean, he knows everything. What is the thing that you remember most from this 7 day in Montreux, which more or less was most of it dedicated, apart from our private moments, which we had also father, son, father, was dedicated to Freddie Mercury and Queen. What is the thing that you remember the most?
For me, it was probably the night of your reading, where so many like dedicated fans and just generally Freddie and Queen fans just came together and just listened and partied, and that was very beautiful to me, that how a group of people can just unite over one person.
I mean, I have to say I was nervous because there was no chance to rehearse. And I, as always, I had a little tricky evening planned. I was always reading a bit, and then there was a video played in on the big screen, and then reading and I was reading 5 chapters in English. Yes, we filmed it. He was the chief cameraman on stage.
Not really.
Well, you were the cameraman on stage.
On stage.
Okay, let's get the chief. For me, he's always the chief because he's my son. If Ruby would have been there, then there's two chiefs.
Of course.
No, but Benny did a great job. There was also Vladimir from the Montreux Celebration team, and then the third person. So we do have a 3-camera a recording of the evening, which, as we speak, is going to be edited, and I'm going to upload at least parts of it, both to Rudi Dolezal's Doro TV on YouTube, as well as on the Freddie Mercury homepage, which is now at Doropolis, where already the foreword and the first chapter are uploaded again for people who were so kind to pre-order the book to shorten the waiting time. We also had a signing session that you also filmed and assisted. Remember that? Tell me, how was that for you?
It was also very inspirational because people from all over the world just came to see you, basically. It was very unreal to see you. Well, I'm not used to my father getting this. Like, I'm not used to...
I'm just daddy, you know?
Yeah, he's just dad, but...
At home, I'm just...
other people, he was just a star, which he is, but it was unusual.
And what was important for that is that I did have two different pieces of art, photographs on which I signed, and I took quite a lot of time. So I made it a little bit similar to what we did for the little prizes for the trivia, if you remember, when I was doing the streaming out of Miami. So I was riding around and, you know, and with different colors. So, and I was talking to everybody because everybody just didn't want to only have a signature. They were asking questions, you know, why is the book not out? And I explained that I had problems with the original worldwide publisher. And again, what I learned from Freddie and Queen is only put it out the way it's supposed to be. And they wanted changes which were impossible in the last moment. They didn't come from the beginning. So I said, okay, take it or leave it, and I left it. So this is why it is delayed. There will be something very important happening in Zanzibar, but I want the Zanzibar Museum, Freddie Mercury Museum in Zanzibar, and Andrea, I want him to again publicize that and announce that and not be a spoiler, but I'll be there. What else? I mean, how did you like Montreux as a town, as a city?
It was very beautiful, very romantic as well. I liked it very much, especially the little Italian place we were at on our day off. Mm-hmm. I'd like to say it was very, very beautiful. It was on like a corner of a street that went, like an alleyway that went up. Mm-hmm. Definitely very beautiful.
Darlings, until this day, Freddie is the person in all my life that influenced me the most. My mentor, my hero, my friend. This book tells it all. Freddie was a special person, and I felt very privileged to call him my friend and to work with him and Queen. This book tells it all.
And then we had one afternoon where after I had a very special meeting, about which I don't want to talk because it was a secret meeting with somebody very important. We were then going to the Freddie Mercury suite.
Yes.
And then we had, on the 5th of September, on the very birthday of Freddie, we were meeting a few very interesting people. Whom do you remember?
We were with one woman. Women, well, more women, but mostly Dr. Lynn Ashby and Anne Morgan.
Okay. Morgan, I think they were staying there.
They
invited us. Yeah. And then we had Barbara Boffa and Melina and Italian friends and other and their friends, and we were filming and enjoying the
birthday.
Freddie's birthday, correct. They had a cake there.
Champagne.
You were drinking champagne?
No, I wasn't. I'm too young.
Okay. He says that when Papa is next to him. I don't know if he does it when I'm not around. But that was also pretty interesting. What did you think of the Freddie Mercury suite?
It was, to be quite honest, underwhelming. It was, as Lynn would say, underwhelming. Or missed opportunity, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. If you'd like to say that. It was not very special. It was like three pictures hanging on the wall. You saw on the last backstage, or on the backstage before that, I'm not sure. I think it was 81 or 82. You saw the pictures behind, but that was pretty much it. It was very, very underwhelming.
What he means, underwhelming for what one could do out of the fact that this is really the suite in which Freddie Mercury was staying a long time. I've been there. There were parties there. There were meetings there. So one could do much more. There was another picture which was signed, and that was about it. But I mean, see, you know, this is the Montreux Palace. So what did you think of the Montreux Palace?
It was beautiful. Like,
is that a great hotel?
Yes. Probably as expensive as.
You can say fuck on Papa's swimming.
It was there, like big stairs at the entrance out of a Disney movie. It was beautiful.
We were filming also something which would be on Krone TV. We were, you know, Krone TV, and also be seen on Krone.at, and I will definitely upload it on with Dolezal's Doro TV on YouTube. We were basically filming not only my reading, but also Queen fans and situations and in the suite and on other. We also were in the studio, so there will be a little mini doc out of the Freddie Celebration 2021 soon, I will keep you posted. And I think it, I mean, I told him, come with me. And he said, Papa, what are we doing there? I said, well, first of all, you can help me with, I call it now the dress rehearsal for the world premiere, because the, it was in front of an audience, yes, but I couldn't rehearse it. No rehearsal time, and it was a very good experience, and everybody who came afterwards they loved it. But still, I want to improve it before I call it the world premiere. But it was basically also to show that there is 5 chapters. I mean, there's actually 40 chapters, but for all the BS that's around, that the book is not, there is no book, well, here it is. And there is more soon. And there is going to be the book soon, but I don't say any dates because it's dependent on publishers in different countries now. But we're getting there. I have a new team around me, which now tries to help me on that. Thing is that I told him it's beautiful, Montreux, in the beginning of September. If we are lucky with the weather, and we were very lucky, although it said after the third day, 80% chance of rain, there was practically no rain. Yeah,
very lucky.
Yeah, and so we missed a few private opportunities. We wanted to go diving, we do this next time. We wanted to go out with a boat. We even had the boat rental, but we didn't make it to the boat. But there was just a lot on our shoulders and on our schedule. Okay? Okay, darlings, this was my great son, Benjamin. Thank you for joining me. He's usually not... Thank you for having me, you know exactly. I mean, I'm so proud of this young man. I'm so fucking proud, I can tell you. Thank you, darling. You and your brother, you are the best thing that happened to me. Thank you very much for viewing this. You know my 3 wishes. I don't have to repeat it. Hope to see you next week. Anything you want to say to the streaming viewers around the world of Rudy Backstage?
I would say never miss a Sunday at 8.
Thank you, Benjamin. See you next time. Love and respect. Bye.
You wanna know what goes on backstage? Oh, come on. Let me take you by the hand. Ow!
Rudy, are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen!
The way I see it, Barry, this should be a very dynamite show.
You know, I have no idea what the name of this program is, but you're watching it.
Backstage.
All you ever want.
Backstage.
All you ever need.
Backstage.
Your dreams will be fulfilled once you are there. You'll never wanna leave. You wanna sell your ass for that backstage pass.
Backstage.
It's just for the invited.
Backstage.
They've laid on everything.